It's a great honor for me to have this presentation. And in the next 15 minutes, I will present minimally invasive, fully implantable left ventricular assist device concept, design, and early prototyping by Alexandru Pleșoianu, Carmen Pleșoianu, Andrei Țăruș, and Grigore Tinică from University of Medicine and Pharmacy and Institute of Cardiovascular Disease from Iași, Romania. We have no conflict of interest, and this is our agenda. Yeah, this year, the new guideline for heart failure was launched by European Society of Cardiology that defines the advanced heart failure as persistent symptoms despite maximum guideline-directed therapy. Unfortunately, the prevalence of this pathology is continuously rising, and one-year mortality can reach up to 75% at 1 year. The present heart failure guideline details the 7 clinical profiles for advanced heart failure patients, according with Interagency for Mechanical Circulatory Support, very useful for setting the right time to address heart failure patients to mechanical circulatory support therapy. Up to 10% from the overall heart failure population who remains severely symptomatic despite optimal guideline-directed management, from which cardiac transplantation or mechanical circulatory support are a last standing resource. Because of limited availability of heart transplants, which is the gold standard, the mechanical circulatory support has come into the spotlight with evidence associating it with increased survival and quality of life in very fragile population. In the evolution of mechanical circulatory support, continuous flow rotary pumps proved that may successfully replace the pulsatile ones, which were initially used. Commercially available left ventricular assist device with continuous axial flow pump are represented by Jarvik 2000 and HeartMate 2, both implanted in human in April, respectively July 2000. Unfortunately, those pumps are not very used anymore, since there are a lot of complications. So important improvements were developed by those companies, but severe thrombosis, bleeding, or infection still limit their clinical use, justifying intense research to create better ones. So materials and in a multidisciplinary team consisting of bioengineer, cardiologists, and cardiovascular surgeons, we have made an extensive analysis of literature data and patent database in the field of mechanical circulatory support. We have identified the main problems associated with this therapy from the perspective of medical team, patient, and also other actors that interact with the device during its life cycle. The concept of the device was created using CSML modeling language in enterprise architect software, taking into consideration the needs of all actors involved in the mechanical circulatory support, patients, healthcare providers, and manufacturers. Mathematical modeling was used to calculate the pump characteristics to deliver 5 liters per minute at differential pressure of 100 millimeters mercury under the size constraints imposed by minimally invasive implantation of the device in a subcutaneous pocket. The conceptual design of the pump was created using turbo machinery design software, CF Turbo, and the detailed design of left ventricular assist device, the implant part, was further refined using SolidWorks software. As a result, in the left side, we can see the use case diagram where the actors were defined and also the use cases that they request or contribute to. In the middle, we have the context diagram where interfaces were defined and what properties are exchanged within those interfaces. And in the right, we have the first layer of decomposing with the white box of the system. We have created a left ventricular assist device for partial support for patients with New York Heart Association class 3-4 heart failure that might pump up to 5 liters per minute of blood from the left side of the heart to the arterial system at a differential pressure of 100 millimeters mercury. The characteristic of device, the actors and the interfaces involved were defined. So the ventricular assist device contains an implant, a controller, rechargeable batteries, charging station, and the console. Here in the pictures, we can see the implant placed subcutaneously, wirelessly receiving the energy from external wearable controller. So the device is designed to be minimally invasive, fully implantable in a subcutaneous pocket in the pectoral area. The inflow cannula is connected to the left atrium, either endovascularly via subclavian vein, superior vena cava, right atrium fossa ovalis, or by surgical endovascularly via subclavian vein. We end with the outflow connected to endovascularly directly to left atrium, and the outflow connected with subclavian artery proximal to the implantation incision. Mathematical modeling was performed aiming to calculate the pump characteristic to comply with the size constraints. Dimensional functional calculus of the hollow axial flow pump were made. From the requested pressure of 100 millimeters mercury and blood density, we calculated the specific work. For impeller diameter, for example, the impeller diameter of 10 millimeters and flow of 5 liters per minute, we derived the specific diameter. On the cordial diagram, the line of optimal efficiency interval, we identified that for the specific diameter, we obtained the value of specific speed. In the second interval of axial pumps, and with the rotational speed of 40,580 rotations per minute and the specific speed of 0.7, we are in a high efficiency area, slightly over 90% efficiency. For the pump's diameter of 12 millimeters, the same calculus showed that 8,340 rotations per minute must to be applied to pump 5 liters per minute at 100 mercury, millimeters mercury. Okay. The conceptual design of the pump was created using Turbo Machinery Design Software, CF Turbo. Firstly, we defined the fluid properties and the design operation point of the pump in terms of total pressure, flow rate, and the rotation speed calculated before. We considered the blood density at 1,060 kilograms per cubic meter, and the design operational point was set to 100 millimeters mercury with a flow of 5 liters per minute. The result was shown in the left figure for a design operational point. And the pump inner part consisting of an inducer, impeller, and diffuser in the right side of the picture was calculated at 30 millimeter length and 10 millimeters diameter. The inducer is an inlet stator with three blades parallel with pump's axis for directing the blood flow. The impeller is a three-blade helical rotor with a wrap angle of 235 degrees and 225 degrees at hub and shroud sections of the pump, respectively, that transform rotational movement into hydrodynamic energy. The diffuser contains three blades that contribute to the axial flow of blood and improve efficiency. The implant consists of electric motor, an axial flow pump, an electronic circuit, a rechargeable battery, and a housing. The motor of the device is an electric brushless DC motor composed by stator, rotor, and magnetic bearings. Specific to this motor are the coreless windings of the stator, the tubular magnetic rotor, and magnetic bearings. The rotor is a two-layer tube, the inner one with structural and shielding role, and the outer one with rotational and bearing role. The tubular shape of the rotor allows the construction of the pump inside of it. The magnetic bearings consist of two components, the inner component attached to the exterior of the rotor and the outer component attached to the housing. The magnetic bearing keeps the rotor suspended inside the stator, allowing the stabilization of the bearing. Another force, electromagnetic or hydrodynamic anyway, have to be involved. The pump contains an impeller embedded inside the rotor, an inducer, and diffuser. Inside the pump, the blood does not encounter areas of significant occlusion, turbulence, or strong electromagnetic field. The surface of the pump and the motor may be covered with amorphous tetrahedral carbon. The electronic system contains a power management block, a microcontroller, a motor driver, and a communication block. The energy wirelessly transmitted from an external source is received through the antenna and distributed to the power management block, both devices operation and battery charging, which is used as internal power source when external source is interrupted. As results for materialization, the design of the pump created in, I have a small delay. So the design of the pump created in CF Turbo was used as input geometry for detailed design of the system in SolidWorks. And from here, several variants of the housing geometry were created and 3D printed with fused filament fabrication technique. The solid models were examined, and we choose one that was materialized with a clear resin stereolithography technique at 25 microns resolution. Okay, discussions. We presented a circulatory assist device characterized by minimally invasive implantation, pumping blood parallel to the heart through a pump built inside the rotor of a brushless electric motor with magnetic bearings, powered by electronic circuit which wirelessly received energy from an extracorporeal source. Internal rechargeable battery ensures autonomy and operation when the external source is interrupted. The pump's rotor assembly levitates magnetically inside the stator. All surfaces in contact with blood may be covered with amorphous tetrahedral carbon. There are several features of the proposed device that have the potential to minimize the complication associated with the market available devices. The main blood pad does not cross the space between stator and rotor. The magnetic bearings allowing the reliability and reduce the risk of cell damage. The amorphous tetrahedral carbon coating reduce the risk of rejection and reduce friction between blood and the pump surfaces. The autonomous functionality provided by internal battery contributes to the increasing of patient's quality of life, and the wireless energy reception reduces the risk of infections that accompanies the penetration of patient skin by electrodes or tubes common to many devices. Further investigation, anyway, must be performed to confirm the mathematical calculus of the pump by computed fluid dynamics and in vitro testing. Furthermore, the concerns regarding stabilization of the bearing system and the risk associated with transcutaneous energy transmission must be addressed. So in conclusion, in a multidisciplinary team, we have created innovative, fully minimally invasive, implantable left ventricular assist device capable to deliver 5 liters per minute of blood at 100 millimeters mercury differential pressure using 12 millimeter internal diameter axial flow pump turned at 8,340 rotations per minute. Also, our work was recognized by the Romanian patent organization, and we have also other applications for patent granting. So thank you very much for attention, and if there are questions.
Thank you for your presentation. Interesting and complex work. Any questions from the audience? No?
No questions.
No questions?
No.
When it will be done?
Yeah, we are now in proof of concept stage, so we are ready to finish the in vitro testing in the this year, in the end of this year, and the next step will be after we pass this testing next year to have the in vivo testing. So in July 2022, I expect that we will have our first implant in animal.
Okay. We'll wait your conclusions.
Yeah.